whilst I am still daily driving KDE Plasma, and that's probably going to be the case for at least a little bit longer, I have been playing around with Cosmic a bit in my own free time, and I stand by what I've been saying. Cosmic is a really great proof of concept. Things like the windowing work really, really well. But being an alpha, there is a lot of alpha level bugs. Surprisingly, I haven't seen a crash though. And also being an alpha, there is a lot of missing features. Wow, imagine that. The alpha software that is marketed as an alpha isn't done yet. It's an alpha. So what I want to talk about today are some of the features I would really love to see sometime down the line. Some of these I would be very surprised if they didn't exist in some form or another. Others are kind of a pipe dream. Whilst there has been work on a global hotkey system built for Wayland making use of portals, this was opened in 2021. It is a closed and complete issue, at least from the portal side, because this is sort of the issue. There is a specification for building a hotkey portal. It's now up to the desktops to implement the portal, and then the applications to implement a way to make use of the portal. But there's a lot of desktops that don't yet have the hotkey portal. So if the desktops don't have the portal, the applications aren't going to implement the portal. As you can see, this is a chicken and egg problem. This is going to be great for applications running under Wayland or applications that are being updated consistently that actually are making use of the portal. Think something like a screen reader that isn't built directly into the compositor. But there are going to be these legacy X11 applications or just older applications that don't ever get updated that you still want to be using and you still want to have global hotkey access, but you can't do it. Now, KDE has a solution to this, that being legacy X11 app support, where basically, if the app is running under X11, X-Wayland is allowed to snoop in on hotkeys being pressed, it's allowed to listen into your keyboard, and then send those keys to those applications. This is the way that I'm doing it with OBS. So if I press, I don't know, F3, my camera moves there, F5, we do that, F4, we're back to here. Without this solution, the hotkeys only function if I'm focused on the OBS window. And that would be fine if I'm just talking and I'm not showing anything on my screen. But if I'm doing things like messing around with a window, typing in a terminal, doing things in my browser, having to move my cursor over to the side every single time is really, really annoying. For me, this is absolutely crucial. Now, for OBS, there are hack workarounds you can do to avoid this, like using one of the WebSocket controllers. But as I said, there are other applications this affects as well, and those ones don't have workarounds. I really want to see something like this in Cosmic as well. Basically, every notable desktop has a window rule system of some degree. It might only be a simple one where it's about window positioning, window sizing, or it might be a really extensive one. But regardless, most of them have one. Cosmic currently doesn't. Again, alpha problems will be alpha problems. I have no doubt that down the line, there is going to be a system. What I really hope they do, though, is learn from the way that Plasma does it. So a lot of window managers have a text-based window rule system where you go and type in, I want it to be this size, I want it to be on this screen, I want it to do this and do that. And because everything in Cosmic is being stored in text files as well, you are going to be able to go and write those by hand. But what I hope they do is have something like this button right here, detect window properties. So let's say I want this window here to be, I don't know, right here and then sized like this. If we go to Tech Window Properties, click on the window, it is going to tell me everything about the window. It's going to tell me the class of the window, the whole window class, the window type, and all of the other stuff here. So if you want to go and say, size it like this, you don't have to guess, okay, how big is that? How many pixels? Oh, is it like 700, 750, I don't really know. What you can do is just size it in the layout and then just grab the property. If you want it to be positioned exactly here, put it there and grab it from the properties. Just having this one button makes window rules considerably more approachable. But even if you knew how to do them through text anyway, it just makes it easier. There's no more guessing, oh, what is this monitor called? Is it DisplayPort 1? Is it DisplayPort 2? Is it the one I have on HDMI? Is it the laptop built-in monitor? No guessing the names. You just put it where you want it, and you're good. Now, Cosmic does a lot of things that don't exist in Plasma, and I feel like those do belong in the window rules as well. Things like whether a window is currently tiling, whether it exists as a stack, and if possible, whether these windows, if spawned together, could automatically stack together. There is only two limitations on window rules. One, the complexity of implementation. There are some really weird ideas you could do, but they might just take way too much time to do. The second reason is complexity for the user. If none of the users understand how the rules work, then they might as well not exist. One of the things I brought up in my Cosmic review is I really like having the option of mouse-based control in my tiler. Now, most tilers do this, but most tilers also have a fairly simple tiling system. So you have moving the windows around and then resizing them. In Cosmic, you have a dedicated swap. You have the stacking and you also have window rotation. And this works really well when doing the keyboard shortcuts. On the mouse though, all of these operations are merged into the same interaction. This feels a little bit weird, and even now using it, it feels a little bit inconsistent. Like if you want to drag a window to the opposite side of another window, it's going to try to stack in the process unless you specifically ignore the center of the window. It just feels kind of buggy, and it feels like it's not doing what the user wants it to do. I think there are two ways you could approach this. One of them is instead of having everything on the same interaction, make use of your other modifier keys. So if you hold down the super key, this can be moving the window like before. If you hold down the alt key, now it could try to do a stack. If you hold down the control key, now it could be an explicit swap. This is the way that I would opt for, but I know some people like the idea of dedicated modes. So with the keyboard-based resizing, like in i3, you press a specific binding, and this is now in resize mode, and hotkeys you were using for different things before are now specifically doing resizing. This could work with the mouse-based operations as well. So you enter swapping mode, you enter stacking mode, and then I guess the default mode, that would be your movement mode. If only one of these could be implemented, I would opt for the former over the latter. Now, another thing I really like about Cosmic is the free-flowing tiling system where splits are based on the window you currently have focused. This is the way the auto-tiling scripts for i3 work. It's how BSPWM works, and it's how the only layout I use in AwesomeWM also works. But that's just me. And I know there are a lot of users out there that do like a more static layout-based system like you would see in DWM, like you would see in Awesome with all of the other layouts, like you also see in things like Cronkite for KDE Plasma, where windows are placed according to a set number of rules. Like, this is the master stack layout where you have one big window and then a stack of smaller windows. You have a grid where windows are placed into a grid. You have monocle mode where one window is always full screened and you can cycle between the other windows and other things like this. Because there is the floating and the tiling system, you can manually emulate these systems, sure. You can place the windows so it looks like a master stack, so it looks like a grid, so it looks like a monocle. Honestly, with monocle, you'd basically want to be doing tabbing anyway. It's effectively the same system. but there's no way to automatically go and do this, and that's the problem. Having a way where you can just say, I want it to always be in a master stack, I don't need to think about it. That is the real power of a tiling system. You don't have to think about the layout. Now, I'm not sure what the best approach for allowing this would be, whether it'd be supporting a third-party layout engine like you see in something like River, or in the same vein, exposing APIs so plugin developers could go and make something that does what they want to do, like you see in KDE Plasma with things like Kronkite and Polonium. Whether or not it'd be a good idea to have layouts like this directly inside of Cosmic and have that System 76 interpretation of what the layout actually is. This is the most logical thing to do, and probably, if they do it, would be the route they go. Or, and this is the real pipe dream suggestion that I don't think I've seen anyone actually do, providing a layout customization engine built into Cosmic itself. So like with window rules, where you can say, I want the window placed here and here and here, do that in the concept of a tiling layout as well. So I spawn one window, it's going to be here. I spawn another, it's going to be here. I spawn a third, it's going to be here. And it's going to be sized like this. You could provide both a GUI and then obviously text-based configuration files for doing this. And you could even have it interact with the window rule system. I have never seen a desktop, outside of ones where they're experimenting specifically with this idea, actually implement this. And I get why, because it's really, really difficult and is going to lead to a ton of problems. But I would like to see something like that at least tested, proof of concepted, to see if it's worth even exploring. Window grouping is a really cool feature that exists in Cosmic's tiling, where you can expand the focus out from a single window out to multiple windows, treating that group as a single window. So you can move that group to another location. You can rotate the group around other windows. You can then take the group, run the stacking binding, and automatically turn the whole group into a single stack. This works really well under two assumptions. One, the windows are directly next to each other. Two, you're not using your mouse to interact. I would love to see the system greatly expanded, because this is one of those features that could really make Cosmic seem unique in the tiling space and make people who use tiling window managers actually want to go and use it. One thing I would like to see is right now you cannot interact with the group using your mouse. If you click on the group with your mouse, it will focus on a single window in the group. Maybe have it be a modifier key or something else you need to press, where you can drag the entire group around. You can do all of the other mouse interactions with the group. I'd also like to see it possible to group windows together that aren't necessarily right next to each other. So a window on the left-hand side of the screen, a window on the right-hand side of the screen. Maybe enter like a grouping mode and you select the different windows and then they're a group. Then you could go and move them, rotate them, make a stack, all of those other interactions you could already do when they are next to each other. This would really expand out the system. I'd also like to see grouping expanded to the floating mode as well. In my mind, there is absolutely no reason why it shouldn't be possible in floating. Even with the system right now where it's only windows directly next to each other, even just that, I think should already work. It doesn't, which makes it a bit more limited of a system. And a lot of the stuff that exists in Cosmic's tiling also exists in floating with the same bindings. So this one thing being missing just feels really odd to me, where it also makes sense in the floating context as well. You want to be moving windows together. You want to be making stacks. It just makes sense the feature is also there. I also want to talk a bit about styling. Currently, roundness settings do exist. Density settings are going to be coming at some point in the future. And I like that this does exist. but I don't like the fact that it only has set amounts of roundness. And I understand why they've done this from a UX perspective, having square, round, rounder, roundest, whatever the terms they use are, does make it easier to test. But much like with the border size, the window gaps, I would like there to be a thing where I can define how much roundness I want, and then with density, how much density I want along a continuum, not just three defined settings. I also don't just want to have a global roundness setting and a global density setting. I would like at least some level of configuration, and I know, again, this is a UX designer's nightmare, but it would just be really nice. Like, I want to have rounded windows, but square buttons. I want to have a rounded hotbar, but square something else. Obviously, it doesn't need to go to the absolute granular level of detail, like this button is round, this button is square, things like that. I'm not expecting something to the level of classic GTK configuration without Libid Wader or something like Qt, but what I would like to see is something sort of in between what we have with GNOME Libid Wader and KDE today. Maybe leaning more towards KDE with more configuration, but I get not wanting to do everything because, again, UX designer's nightmare. But this is just the things that I would like. So let me know what you would like to see. Is there anything about the floating mode, or maybe the way that Iced works, or something else out there that seems exciting to you? I would love to know. So if you liked the video, go like the video. And if you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, Scribes, Liberope linked in the description down below. That's gonna be it for me, and it's not ready yet, but you should certainly try Cosmic. Like this.